has emerged that KCCA is grappling with a huge cash shortfall worth 80 billion shillings arising from uncollected revenue. KCCA officials led by Executive Director Jennifer Musisi informed the Watchdog Parliamentary Public Accounts Committee that they inherited 100 billion shillings revenue shortfall in uncollected money from the defunct KCC, but only 14 billion shillings has been recovered.
And the gross arrears receivable as at 30th June 2013 is 83.6 billion.
They told lawmakers that of the outstanding 80 billion shillings, 25 billion would be written off because the authority cannot trace the debtors.
Walk this committee through an explanation as why you think the 25 billion can't be recovered.
Reasons for recommending write-off is that we've been unable to trace documentation relating to them or documentation relating to their whereabouts.
Some of the debtors include vendors at Nakawa and Bugorobi markets and street parking management company Multiplex.
While it is alleged that the Nakawa Market Vendors Association were the one running the market, it is the Nakawa Market Vendors Association Limited that was awarded the contract, which made it difficult to enforce recovery.
The company is in question close or they are still subsisting?
The company in question, Madam Chair, cannot even be traced.
So we fault you for risking taxpayers' money.
But some MPs accuse KCC officials of colluding with the debtors to deny Kampala taxpayers the services that the 25 billion shillings will be used to deliver.
Why not to take on that company which is on the ground and they lead you to help you so that you get the other company which you fail to trace?
Could you be dealing with some big untouchable individuals in town who own these companies?
KCCA Chief Executive Jennifer Musisi also came under fire for using up billions of shillings without the oversight of the council, the Lord Mayor, and the KCCA Public Accounts Committee.
The authority made a decision in an authority meeting. The challenge is that that decision was not concluded legally in the sense of signing the minutes of that meeting.
But Musisi blamed the embattled Lord Mayor Elias Lukwago, whom she said failed to sign the minutes of the council meeting that approved the names of the KCCA Public Accounts Committee nominees.
Now, I wanted to know, now who failed to sign the minutes?
The Lord Mayor.
Jingo Francis, NTV Parliament.